Morning, it's Friday. Hello, it's January 29th. We're gonna dance three dances and they're pretty easy dances this week. And if we get time, we'll add a fourth. That fourth one is a really great one I was planning for next week. So let's see how we go today, okay? They're all party dances that you can use when we celebrate the end of this COVID mess, okay? We're gonna start with one called Bienvenue, Maeva. It's brand new and it's a very easy merengue style dance. Okay, we should get through this quickly. All right, but it's a lot of fun, especially if you're going to have a huge group of people. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, nothing really hard. We're going to start with a chassé to right, a chassé to left, and then we repeat. Okay, but we need it to have a bit of not a jive chassé action, not this kind of action, okay? I want a simple Latin style, move to the side, move to the side, move to the side, move to the side, okay? So you want to have fun with it, you're going to swing your hips. So when you move to the right, take your right hip, then left, then right, then left, right, left. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. Okay, or okay, so the count is actually going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do you have to move your hips from side to side? No, no. You can just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But to keep it less like a jive and more like a Latin style, don't be on the ball of the foot, okay? Try to keep your heels flat. The music has a... you'll see in a minute, the music has a very African kind of rhythm to it, and you're going to feel to do that, okay? You're going to feel that you want to swing your hips from side to side, okay? So how did we do? Everybody okay? Let's do it again with the count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, fantastic. Part two, we're just going to stomp your feet. And then do a cucaracha, and stomp your feet. So we count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And of course, I want you to add a little hip action. So when you stomp your feet, we're going to call this, the name escapes me, time step, right? So 1, 2. So as you place your weight into your, you're going to stomp your right foot. That means your left hip is going to be slightly displaced with a straight leg. You can see my leg is locked straight. So I'm going to stamp. And as I do, I'm going to let my left hip drop slightly back. And then I'm going to change and let my right hip drop slightly back. And if you really want to add some flavor to it, you're going to let your lower body rotate. Okay? So this little Latin technique now. All right, sorry. You don't have to. It can be just on the spot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Or you can add a little rotation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you keep your shoulders steady. You just let the bottom half of you turn as you push one leg straight, okay? 1, 2. All right, let's try part one and part two together. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You end with straight right leg and your hip back. Transfer your weight. We're going to do an out, out, in, in. That means take your right foot diagonally forward, take your left foot diagonally forward, bring your weight back into the center with your right foot, and then back again to the left. So this is called an out, out, in, in. Great name, because the name is the description of the step. What I like to do on this step, we repeat it twice, okay? So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is ball to flat, ball to flat, ball flat, ball flat. All right. When you go forward on the right, I want you to pick up your right hip. Just push your right hip up and then your left hip up. Then come back, right hip slightly back, left hip slightly back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, no, you do not have to. It could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. March it is great. Marching also fits the music, but this is a lot of fun, okay? Again, you keep your shoulders steady and pick up your hip, come back, up, up, back, up, up, back. It's fun, okay? Let's do part 1, 2, and 3 all together. Ready? And 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7, out, 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 in, out, out, in. We have a half a turn to make from here. Half a turn to our left, and we're gonna do that paddle step. An 8 plus an 8 plus an 8 plus an 8. So you step forward on the right foot, ball of foot, turn your left foot an 8. Step forward, turn an 8. Step forward, turn an 8. Step forward, turn an 8. You end up with your feet open and ready to start again, okay? So when we do a paddle, you can just do it like a march. You can do step, turn, 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 okay? So you have a half a turn over the whole 8 beats, or you can add, you see from the side, a hula hoop action, right? That action, and it would be counterclockwise, taking your left hip up and then your right hip, just around in a little circle. So as I go forward, I want to circle back and around. Yes, just as if you've got a hula hoop. You all remember, we remember hula hoops, okay? All right, so you may do that, or, I mean, this one is a little bit more awkward because there's such a small amount of turn, but you could just pick up your hip, just kind of like a little bump, 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 bump. I find that one works better when you have a half, a quarter plus a quarter. But of course, we're on our own and we're in our own place and it's private and you are welcome to do whatever you like. And this dance actually encourages you to be a little crazy because it's not too fast. The music is, what's the word? It gets into your brain and it makes you want to do stuff, okay? So it's a really great party dance. We're going to do the whole thing from top to bottom, and then we'll discuss a couple of little glicks, okay? Ready? We go to the right. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7, 8. Out, out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A paddle and a paddle and a paddle and a paddle and start again. All right. So it has 2 walls and 32 counts. Okay. So this is wall 1. This is wall 2. This would be wall 3. At the end of wall 3, we'll end at wall 4. Okay. At 6 o'clock. And we have a restart here after 16. So let's dance wall 3 into wall 4 and our restart, okay? So this is wall 3. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and we start. Again, this is wall 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6. Restart. 1 and 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so we only do the first 16 beats of wall 4 at the end of wall 3. Wall 4, wall 6, and wall 8. So wall, anyway, the next 3 times we're facing 6 o'clock, we have the restart. So 3 times in a row, we restart, we do this wall, and then we finish, and when we get here, we only do the 16. The music is really obvious, you can't mistake it, okay? You will be forced into doing that, okay? It's really, really clear. So we'll do it one more time, and then we'll put the music on. Ready? To the right. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And a one, two, a three, four. Let's do it one more time. Seven, join me together. One and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. One, two, three and four, five and six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And I'll add one more time just so that we have it down. And one and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. One, two, three and four, five and six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, and now we're ready for music. Yes, La Maeva is called Bienvenue. Maeva is the name of the dance. Brand new, comes from France, and the music is just fantastic. Here we go. Starts right away. So that's a good party dance. I love that one. The more you do it, I think the more you're going to love it. Maybe the first time it's a little bit, you know, not as great, but keep playing it because it's fun. All right, good. So our second one, I'm going to move on. All right. I'm going to move on to the second one. Okay. This one is also this improver level, but it's very, very simple. There's one little tricky part, but we'll go through it slowly. And this is the name of it is No sé por qué te quiero. Okay, also brand new and a bit merengue-ish. Okay, not as fast. All right, we're going to start with a grapevine to our right. So we're going to step to the side on the right, step across, step to the side, and your heel. It's not really a grapevine, the grapevine is behind. So this is in front. Okay, so a weave. Okay, so side, across, side, heel. Then side, across, side, heel. Good. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Again. One, two, three, four, all flat on the foot. No ball of foot. And it's going to be about that speed, not too fast. So walk side and walk across. Yes, good. Now we're just going to walk back for four steps with the merengue action. Ball flat, ball flat, ball flat, ball flat. So one, two, three, four. Okay, what do you do with your arms? Hold them out, let your shoulders do a little shimmy. Yes, shimmy a lot. Woo! Whatever you feel like doing, okay? Have some fun. I want you to play with these ones. So we're going to do this part into our next part. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Back. One, two, three, four. Rock five. Replace six. Step seven. Tap eight. All right? So going back, right foot, right, left, right, left. Make sure you put full weight on it. Your right foot is free. Take your right foot back without moving your left. Replace the weight into the left foot. Step forward, right, and tap left to right. Do that one more time. Right, back, right, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, tap. You need to be free on your left foot. Okay, part one and two together. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Back, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Fabulous. We do a chasse forward on the right foot. You may do it as a lock step if you like, or just step together step. It's going to be left, right, left. Okay, again, left, right, left. See, I did two different ways. I did one with just a basic step together step, and the second version I did step, lock, step. So your choice absolutely doesn't matter what you do. All right, but it's left, right, left, the count one and two. On count three, you're just gonna drop your weight back into that left foot, right foot, and as you do, let your left foot rondé. So we're dancing one and two, three. On four, that foot is going to rondé. Four. And turn one quarter to your left. So you can rock back on five, replace on six, chasse left, right, left, seven, and eight. I'm going to dance that from this direction so you can see what I'm doing. I'm going to dance part two and part three. So we walk back on the right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One and two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. I guess that part's slightly tricky. Let's do that again. Right foot forward. One, two. Sorry, that was the end, seven, eight. One and two, three, three, bent knee, let that scoop forward. Last week we learned how to do a rondé. So if I step back, I'm still going to take that foot forward first. I'm not going to go back and back. I'm going to step back into a flex knee and let that foot be forward. Then use the strength of this leg to turn. And you see that I allow my right foot to pivot. Make sure you allow your right foot to pivot. Don't just leave that and try to go here, okay? Allow, so you're gonna step, do it from this direction. You step back on a right foot, and you see what I did? Kind of pushed my left foot forward right away. I don't wanna go back with it. I wanna let it go forward and then circle around. I keep thinking of those, I think it's a protractor, you know, in the math. This is the center, this is where it sticks into the paper, and this is the other little post that goes around and makes a nice little circle. So I want to do one, five, so what is that, count three? Three, four, and I allow my turn. Now the foot is behind, I'm going to do five, six, and chasse, seven, and eight. All right, I'm going to do that part one more time, and I'm going to dance it this way. So this is one and two. Three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. All right, part four, a new step, I believe, is called the heel grind. it's going to replace a rock step. So if you don't like the heel grind, or if you're in a position where it's kind of putting you off balance because we're going to just use the heel of our foot, you can absolutely do a rock step, okay? But we're going to do this. I'm going to dance this, this way. No, I'm going to dance this facing you so you can see. So I put my heel in front on a flexed supporting leg, and then I'm just going to grind, turn in and out. Yes? One, two. One, two. Okay? So from this direction, one, two. Something nice to do is to add a swivel with the other foot. So as I see, I'm going to turn my left toe out, left toe in. So heel, grind. Into one, two, three, four. Rock step. Okay, so one, two, three, four. Again, if that is bothering you, this is causing you discomfort or to be unbalanced, replace it with a rocking chair. Just do rock, 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 rock. Gets you the same position and it's just as nice. All good, okay? So that's count one, two, three, four. So one, two. I'm always going to add the swivel. Yes? One, two, three, four. And just like the other dance, we have the paddle turning a half to our left, but we're using a quarter plus a quarter. So five, six, seven, eight. And I'm going to do the hula hoop again. So it's forward right, circling your hip behind, forward right foot, circle the hip behind. Or because you're turning a quarter plus a quarter, using your hip here makes sense. You might feel to do that. Okay? So let's put the whole thing together. All right, from the top. A walk, two, three, four. A walk, six, seven, back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, tap. One and two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. A quarter plus a quarter. So overall, we turned a quarter to our right by turning three quarters to our left. All right, I'm going to dance it again, and I'm going to dance it two times in a row. All right, ready? And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Back, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One and two, three, four, five, six, seven and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Again, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One and two, turn a quarter, five, six, seven and eight. One, two, three, four, a quarter, plus a quarter. One more time. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One and two, turn. Five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Fantastic. That's how easy the dance is, except one little tag. We have a 32 beat tag, okay? So they're going to call it part B, and we only have it one time. And it happens when we get to 9 o'clock after wall 9, okay? So this is wall 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So wall 9 is the second time, actually including the beginning, the third time we hit 12 o'clock. We go through the whole routine as normal, and it will end here, okay, at 9 o'clock. What is that, 3 o'clock? Okay, so it looks like this. We're going to dance. One, two, three, four. Like the beginning of the normal part A. So, sorry. Side, across, side, heel. Now, from here, turning one quarter to your left. I'm going to do this from this position so you can see. One, two, three, four. This is the position we're going to be in anyway. On step 5, I want you to turn one quarter to your left, a big side step, and just drag that foot in for 3 more beats. Okay? So it looks like this. One, two, three, four. Oh, God. Five, six, seven, eight. Okay? Now, rock, rock, walk, walk. Rock, rock, walk, walk. All right, let's do that again. One, two, three, four. How do you do your walk? It can be a little prissy walk, can be just a little basic walk, can be a merengue walk, can be a pushing walk, whatever you like, okay? I don't know how much room you've got. The music is kind of medium, not really too fast, but it kind of happens so quickly I don't have time to think about the walk, and it only happens once, all right? So I'm gonna do from the part B, part one of part B. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. On count five, take your right foot across your left, putting your weight into your right foot, okay? Now you have a twisty action between your feet here, you have a cross. You're gonna unwind one full turn to your right and to your left, and leave your weight on your right foot. So you're turning, I'm gonna do it slowly, you're turning around your right foot to the left. You end here, okay? So this is gonna happen over one half a bar of music. So this is count five. On six, you start turning, six, seven, eight. You're gonna leave your weight on your right foot. Your left foot has to be free. Okay, so this is part two of B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, that's not that easy to do, especially if you're on carpet. So I'm gonna say, let's find a replacement if you want. 1, 2, 3, 4. How about 5, 6, 7? No, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, rock, replace, step, tap. That would be a good, you need to be free on your left foot, so that would be a good replacement if you don't want to do that full turn. Let's practice the full turn one more time, and then I'll show you one more time the replacement if you want. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keeping your weight on your right foot, left foot has to be free. Okay, or we decided, all right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Rock, rock, step, tap, instead of cross, turn, turn, hold. Then, forward tap, step, grande, rock, rock, side, close. We took out the chassé. Okay, so this is the same as before. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Close your feet, change weight. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The second time we tap. And now we're back to our beginning. We only do this one time at the end of wall nine, all right? So we are here at the end of wall nine. We were here, we did 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Step, close, left foot is free. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you make a mistake at the end and you do a chassé, doesn't matter, you're still free on the right foot, so it's good, okay? So don't worry about that. So I'm gonna do wall nine into our part B, and then into wall, I guess that would be 11 after that, okay? So wall 10 is our part B, wall nine is part A. We're gonna do A, B, A, all right? Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Part B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, back to A, five, we'll do the whole thing. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One and two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, etc., etc. Okay, I'm gonna do that again because it's hard. And the thing about it, it will be very obvious in the music. Like, the music actually comes to almost a stop, okay? You can't hear the beat anymore. So you have to remember, just follow me, I'll try to do it. You have to remember the tempo of the beat of what you've been dancing earlier to keep it while you do part B. So it is a little bit tricky. I think that's why they made it an improver level and not a beginner level. The rest of it is pretty easy, but that part has that little trick. So just stick with me because I've done it a few hundred times now and I think I've got it. So we're gonna try again one more time before putting the music on. We're gonna do part nine, wall nine, which is part A, wall 10, which is part B, and wall 11, which is part A. All right, so let's do wall 9, 10, and 11. Ready? One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, part B. 1, 2, 3, 4, slide. There's no music here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oops. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Part A. We're back to the beat. You can't miss it. It comes back. Okay? I made a mistake. I'm going to do it one more time. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7 and 8. Oops. 1, 2, 3, 4. I won't make that mistake. Part B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cross and turn 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we start again. Might as well do it. Yes. 1, 2. You ready for the music? 5, 6, 7, 8. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, you ready for the music? All right, so part B happens at the after the third time we hit 12 o'clock. Okay, it's called No sé por qué te quiero. Again, brand new. They can say it's 64 counts, but I guess it is. Here we go.
Elle me dit j'ai senti bon. même quand c'est une petite galère, tu vas crier misère. Au final, il y en a toujours un qui va chanter les guerres. Dans ce monde, il y a des guerres. Et les espèces individuelles. Dans ce monde, il y a des guerres.
I love that one. I got a lot of fun out of it. You can really like really play with it, you know, maybe have a few drinks and do this one. It's kind of good. The disco lights on, whatever. All right, our next one is a salsa, brand new salsa called Let It Be. I think it just came out this week. Thank you very much for our wonderful choreographers from Indonesia. This is a fun dance. It's 64 count, but it's a beginner level. The music is not very fast. It's an old Beatles song, and I think that it's great. Okay, so I'm going to take my time with it because I think this will be one that you're going to enjoy. All right, we'll dance this after the pandemic is over. We're going to start with your weight on your right foot into a basic mambo, forward and back. Left foot forward, right foot back. So you're going to dance rock, replace, step, rock, replace, step. All right, one more time. Left, right, left, right. We count 1, 2, 3, hold 4, 5, 6, 7, hold 8. Doing the same thing, but adding one full turn. All right, we're gonna split the first half of that bar, the 1, 2, 3, 4, into two half turns. And the 5, 6, 7, 8, you will have completed your turn. So to explain that, you're standing on your right foot, we're gonna dance forward on the left into a spot turn to our right, okay? So leave your right foot on the spot, but pivot around it. Step forward left, replace the weight to a not moving, didn't move, stayed on the spot, right foot. Okay, so this is going to be 1, 2. On count 3, 4, as you put your weight into your right foot, you're going to complete the turn with a spin on your right foot, closing your left to right. Okay, so it looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it looks really complicated, but it's a half plus a half. Don't think you have to spin one full turn. You're going to step forward. There's your half a turn. And now just wind up the left side of your body, right? All you have to do is go back half a turn. And close your feet. If you don't have a perfect close, it doesn't matter. 1, 2, 3, 4. Step back. It's all good. It still is good. Half a turn plus a half. The thing is, you're turning from your right foot. That's important. So you step forward left, pivot your left foot and your right foot. Now spin on the right as you, doesn't matter where you put that foot, okay? Your next step, you rock back, replace, forward. Okay? If we were going to compete, I would say close your feet, all right? Because it's tidy, all right? But if you're dancing by yourself in your room, you know, you don't want to fall. I don't want anybody to fall.
I just want you to end up with one full turn. If one full turn is not possible, repeat the first part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It gets you the same spot as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes? Rock, rock, turn. Rock, rock, step. Yes? Rock, rock. That was your turn, first half. Spin, rock, rock, step. All right, you don't want to look down when you do a spin. That's the number one rule, all right, of a spin. Do not look at the floor. Keep your head up and look where you want to end up. I want to end up forward, so I'm going to stay forward. I'm going this way. Now I'm going to look where I'm going, which will be forward. Keeping your eyes not parallel, okay? Don't look down. Don't look up. Just look straight, okay? Second thing, make sure that your supporting feet are doing the pivoting, okay? You can't leave the foot there and try to, I don't know how to mess it up too much, okay? I can make a lot of messes, but in this case, in order for me not to get a broken ankle or a twist or whatever, I want to make sure my supporting feet continue to turn. Okay, that's number two. Number three, whenever you're doing a spin, if I'm spinning to the right, the opposite side of the body has to initiate the turn. Okay, so I don't want to do turn, turn, and now try to turn my right side. All it's going to make me do is fall. I want to do, I'm going to start this way so you can see from my back. I'm going to start forward, forward. Now you see I slightly left my left side behind. I'm forward, but I left that side behind because I'm going to use it to wind up. I'm going to use my back ribcage to pull around. It's going to be this. My left side does the work, not my right. So, and I'm only asking for half a turn. It's not a huge amount of turn, all right? Of course, if it's uncomfortable, just replace it with no turn. One turn and no turn gets you to the same spot. You just have to mark the time. So one time with the turn, okay, from the beginning. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Or if you don't want to turn, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. They're both absolutely fantastic. I will be doing the spin because I love it, okay? Then we are standing on our right foot. We're going to do a volta to our right and a volta to our left, a very short version, so we're going to call it a cross-chasse with a hitch. So the first one is left foot comes across, forward, release the back heel, and across. And as you bring that foot in front, lift the knee up, and then across and across. Okay? So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold 8. Again, you're standing on your right foot, left foot comes in front. Cross and cross up. Cross and cross. And we've learned from other lessons that when you do a hitch, if you want, it's going to feel, especially if it's a salsa or a samba or a jive action, you want to feel that somebody has punched you in the gut and the reaction is a pull. All right? So it's like you shorten your stomach and it pulls up your knee. All right? You don't, if you want. Okay? So it's this. And it's like a little bit of a sweep to give it some strength, okay? So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, a basic cumbia style step. We're going to step 1, kick, back, replace, step, kick, back, replace. The kick is just to mark time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You don't have to, you can just leave the foot on the floor. Okay, it could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, the kick is diagonal, and it's like there's something on the top of your shoe, not the bottom. It's not that, it's that. a downward action. So, one flick, rock, step, step, flick, rock, step. Okay? Let's go from the beginning to there. Forward, left. One, two, three, hold four, five, six, seven, hold eight. One, two, three, hold four, five, six, seven, hold eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. All right, next half. We do a weave to our left. Side, behind, side, forward. This part will feel fast. It's gonna be one, two, three, four. Rock five, replace six with a quarter turn to your right. I might be off the time here. Let's dance that. Seven and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Hold eight. Just hold eight, okay? Again, we're here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold eight. This is behind, okay? So you're standing on your right foot. Left side, right foot back. Left side, right foot forward. Okay? Little zigzag. One, two, three, four. Rock five, six, seven, hold eight. Next part, part six. We dance a mambo on our right and left, but we're gonna turn a quarter to right. So we're gonna dance forward right. One, two, three, and on four, a little tap, four. Five, six, side, hold eight. Okay, so I wanna do that part again. We're gonna dance right foot, forward and back, tap, back and side, no tap, just side. You can tap if you feel like it, okay? So again, the count, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold eight. That was a quarter turn to your right. So let's put five and six together. You're standing at the end of your cross, or at your, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. If you don't feel to do that little tap, don't do it, okay? Doesn't matter. Now, next part, I'll dance it this way. We're gonna dance from here. We're gonna dance forward, side, back. Back, side, forward. All right, that will be facing you. Let me dance this part. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. Wrong end on four. Five, six, seven, eight. Hold eight. Last part, diagonal. Forward with a tap. Back with a kick forward, coaster step. So the last part, one, two, three, four, back right, feet together, weight on the left, forward right. Okay, part six, and you know what, let's just do the whole thing from the beginning. All right, we'll come back to that. And right, left foot forward. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 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 One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold eight. All right, I'm gonna dance it again. There's one thing I wanna say. The first weave is side behind. So to make that foot go behind naturally, I had a very slight turn to my right. if I turn slightly to my left, the foot's going to go forward. So I go slightly, see, I sort of go diagonals, okay, to make it easy. So after we did our cumbia, we dance one, two, three, four. So the first one is behind. This one is after you do your side step here, this one is forward. So I'm going to do that here. This is part six. One, two, three, four, five, six. When you turn a quarter to left, to right, quarter to right, underturn it very slightly so that you have your right side slightly in front. So that will make that naturally go forward. Okay. If you did five, six, seven, and you turn exact or even more sometimes, it's going to be hard to take that foot forward. But if you do, it doesn't matter. Go back, side, rendez forward instead. Okay? It doesn't matter. All right, but it is the first one we step behind, the second one we step forward. So I'm going to do the second one again. So, and I'm going to underturn slightly. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Then diagonal tap, back, kick, back together, forward. That's the whole dance. No tags, no restarts, slow music. All right, let's go from the beginning all the way to the end. We'll go through it twice. Ready? And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 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 One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four. We're going to start again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Hold eight. We good? Remember what is a coaster? Back together, forward. Five, six, seven, hold eight. Okay, I think we're ready for the music. All right. Yeah, good. Let's do it from the top. It's called Let It Be Salsa. Let It Be Salsa. Okay. Thank you.
I'll save my samba for next week. Okay, it's a great new one, but we'll do Let It Be one more time. Okay, here we go. Squirrel and my mind just went blank. Anyway, all right, I'm going to redo that one all over again in 3 minutes by itself on a separate video. So if you want to watch, I'm going to reteach it quickly and dance it again, and that's it. Okay, so have a great week. We'll be here next week. I've got at least two new really fun samba styles, and we'll see what else I can come up with this week. Have a great one. Thank you so much for tuning in. Bye-bye.